the opponents to the tax measure that you mentioned a couple of years ago cited as one of the reasons for the opposition inefficiency of DOTT and threw out a figure of 11% as being the amount of state taxes that was spent on actual concrete and bridge construction. Garrett Graves reinforced that figure.
An estimated 89% of the funds that are derived from state gas taxes go to expenses inside the building at the Department of Transportation, not outside on turning dirt.
Jay Darden was a guest here sometime back. He said he didn't have a clue what the percentage is.
The CFO of the state, can you give us the approximate percentage that is devoted in DOTD to administrative costs and your assessment of whether you think there could be further efficiency there?
I can't give you that exact percentage, but I'm not going to hazard a specific guess.
Can you give us the approximate, the current day, approximate percentage of state-funded gasoline taxes that are spent on actual bridge and road construction?
Yes, I can explain the difference, I guess. Well, the question is about the 11% and how much of state gas taxes are spent actually on a project. Let me preface this by saying the $800 million I get from the federal government comes with strings. Mm-hmm. And the strings is that you've got to have a 20% match or a 10% match. Some of that can be 100% for the safety projects and the type there are. So a portion of our state gas taxes are used to provide that necessary 10% or 20% match on that $800 million. And that comes to anywhere from 10 to 13%. The remaining portion of our obligations, none of the federal funds can be used for the operation and maintenance of the existing system. So the portion that remains is what we use to take care of the existing system. The mowing, the lights, the cable barrier replacements, guardrail replacements, hurricane response, all of the other things that we do other than construction is paid for out of the state gas tax. And that's the model that every other state in the nation uses. It would be foolish of me to take 100% of my state money to go build something and not be able to take care of it, and use 100% of the federal money to go build something else and not be able to take care of it. And so we're following the national best practice model and the requirement of law that says you have to do your due diligence to take care of what you've built. And your stewardship agreement says you have to maintain these other things that we no longer at the federal government pay for. People tend to take infrastructure for granted and assume somebody's going to cut the grass. They will, and that comes with a cost. Someone has to pay the utility bill for that signal head. That's a cost to the state. Those aren't things that the federal government is going to maintain. Neither are the things like dewatering interstates and de-icing roads. That's all coming out of the state's responsibility in terms of what we have to maintain.
Okay, thank you.